I want to show you guys the latest version, which I got in January. This is the CAA Micro Roni MCK. There are quite a few modifications to this. One of them being in this newer version, the stabilizer is actually a little bit longer. I think it's about maybe 2 inches longer. In some of my previous videos, I talked about the me modifying this where it just kind of hangs straight down, because it is really an arm strap where you could strap it to your arm, because it's, you know, a stabilizer, where I rolled it up like this and kind of just tightened it in. According to the ATF, there's a document out that supports that this stabilizer is legal for you to shoulder it. So modifying that in a sense that you're just simply wrapping it up tight, you're good to go, according to the ATF. Again, this is the MCK, so I'm going to talk about the few modifications to this. I don't know which Glock you have. I carry the Glock 19X, as you can see, empty. I carry the Glock 19X because I love this gun. This is an amazing gun. But enough about that. This Micro Roni is actually designed for about 4 or 5 different models of the Glock 17, 19, 24. But when I applied for to get this MCK, I had to make sure that I picked the right model, which was adapted to this. Now, I don't know if many of you guys know, but if you're carrying the 19 like me, you can't really hardly see it, but inside of there is 19 and 17. So if you have a Glock 19, you take these screws and you slide this part back and screw it in the 19. If it's a 17, you slide this forward. When you slide this forward, it's going to say 17 right here. You slide this forward and then you put these two screws here into the 17 hole. Now it fits a Glock 17. Ta-da! One of the other modifications to the MCK is this gripping ability right here, which I love this. I mean, it just fits perfect in your hand. It has a few options for like this light release. This filler, this block that's right here, it's just a filler. I didn't buy this option, but there's a light that goes right here that you could use, that you can buy with the extra package. And then these are the release. So on your Glock, there's a small rail in the front right here. And this release, these clip onto that rail. So when you lock the gun in, these clip into it. And in order to release the gun, you actually just pull down on these and then pull back on the gun. And I'll demonstrate that in just a few minutes. One of the other new features is this magazine. And all it is that you can just put your magazine in here. Now, I always do this backwards because I'm looking at it backwards. But you can put your magazine in here, and I just like to use it as like a small handle in the front. I really struggled getting this. I really, really struggled getting this out. And I apologize about the focus. I'm still working on this. I really struggle getting this out because this design, there's not really a clip that locks and holds it and you press something and it comes out, but you just struggle hard to pull down on it. And then I found out if you just put your thumb right here and pull, comes right out. Holy crap. Well, anyway, another cool feature. Because this is the MCK, this slide that actually locks into the the back railing system on your Glock no longer comes out. It stays in here stable, which is super, super cool. The other aspect to this model is that you'll notice there's no longer the lock release. So before, they had this crazy little button in here that you could, you know, kind of like lock your slide, right? And then it didn't really work well, and you kept, I'm having a hard time getting to it. And you had a hard time getting to that. Well, now, there she is. He's opened it up. Now you can get right into here to actually to release your slide. You don't have to worry about that little mechanism anymore. Wow, what can I say about this? This is a blast. You know, this can increase your range on a Glock to something like 100 yards, I think. Something like that. I think that's something that they quoted. I've yet to try to shoot this that far. But I'm just going to show you guys. I'm going to actually just, I'm going to put it together real quick to show you guys how quickly it actually goes together. And then I'm going to show you how easy it is to actually get the weapon out. Let's go over this locking mechanism here, this little latch. In order to open it up, you just simply press, and you'll see these little two little notches. There's a pin that goes in and slides up. So you pull down and then pull out. So push in the button, pull down, pull out. So once this is out, super easy. You just get the slide set all the way to the back. You'll see the notches in here, right up here near the front. You'll see the little notching. You just take your weapon, get it close to the back like this. And I would actually struggle doing this. Wow. Oh, I'll edit this out for sure. I'm just going to do it the way I normally do it, which is I set it down like this, put it in there, and push it down. Okay. Then you push it forward, and you hear this little click. That little click was these locking in on the rail so that it stays super tight. Now, again, if you have slop, you might have this set on a 17, which is the barrel is out further, or this little, it's not really even a barrel. It just kind of goes around the outside circumference of the gun. It may be on a 17 and you're using a 19 and now you get a little slop in there. So that might be where, if you feel slop, that might be what this is from. In order to finish this, assembly, just push in on this gate, push in and close it, and then push up. Now she's in place. Now you just pull your little charging handle. She's ready to go. I didn't use the iron sights. The iron sights, if you shoulder it like me, which is completely legal according to the ATF, if you shoulder it like me, the rear aperture is so close to your eye that it's too big. It doesn't allow you to, you can see the front sight, but it's dancing around and there's really no way for you to gauge that you're actually, how your sight is actually aligning. So you're just kind of guessing, you know, there's no point of reference here. So I took that off. I put a green dot on. I got this green dot from Amazon and it cost about maybe $20-$30. Really super cheap. So cheap to the fact that this laser really doesn't work very well. It doesn't turn on and off properly, and I'm sure I can fix that. But wow, holy crap. An extension to the Glock 19 like I've never seen to any Glock. I think this is just a beautiful modification that allows you to do a lot of things. On these Picatinny rails here in the front, the extra package comes with where you have this little thumb rest, and you can actually like rest your thumb against it. It has this little flat plate here. It also comes with a sling swivel that goes for here, as well as the sights and your flashlight that goes in right here. So this extra package, I think it's like $199. CAA Gear Up, I think is the name of the company. The name of the product is a CAA Micro Roni, R-O-N-I. And this is the MCK, which is the latest version that just came out. This is the Feel Dark Earth, and I absolutely love it. It's an incredible gun, or incredible modification to the Glock 19, which is actually pretty cheap. When you look at all the mods that you can buy for your guns, you'll spend hundreds of dollars easy. This is a couple hundred dollars, and wow, look at it. I mean, tactical looking, fun, stabilizes your 9mm in ways you haven't ever expected before, and you're able to get a little bit of a longer distance out of it because you can actually shoulder it legally. You can shoulder it. I say if you've got a Glock and you don't have one of these, get you one. Enjoy it. Make sure that as you progress in your gun collections, or as you progress in learning your weapons, this is another extension to your weapon that I think everybody should have. Enjoy.